Hello, my name is Harith. I'm a Senior Edge Specialist Solutions Architect at Amazon Web Services. Welcome to a short talk on AWS WAF Managed Rules. This widely used feature is a pride and joy for us and our customers. What I would like to tell you here today is what is this feature, how to configure AWS WAF Managed Rules, and finally show you how to begin using them. Before we get started, I would like to talk about AWS WAF. AWS WAF stands for AWS Web Application Firewall. This is our cloud-native firewall that operates by monitoring and blocking HTTP-based communications based on the layer 7 rules that our customers configure. It runs with different integration points, and our customers love to use this service to protect their applications from a variety of layer 7 attacks and also perform intelligent threat mitigation. AWS Managed Rules work with AWS WAF. AWS Managed Rule groups are a collection of predefined, ready-to-use rules that AWS and its marketplace sellers offer for our customers. In this video, I'll be talking about benefits of AWS WAF Managed Rules and also how to configure them. But feel free to check out our marketplace Managed Rule groups too. They are available by subscription through AWS Marketplace. I'll go ahead and talk about some of my favorite features with AWS WAF Managed Rules. Automatic updates. Keeping up to date on the constantly changing threat landscape can be time consuming and expensive. Managed Rule groups can save customers this time and money when you implement and start working with AWS WAF. AWS and its marketplace sellers automatically update these managed rule groups and provide newer versions of rule groups when new threats emerge. Zero-day protection. In some cases, AWS, due to its participation in number of private disclosure communities, can update these AWS WAF managed rule groups and deploy them for our customers before a threat is widely known, so thereby offering zero-day protection. Restricted access. To protect the intellectual property of the rule group providers, including AWS WAF managed rules, your customers cannot view the details of the individual rules within the rule group. Having this restricted access keeps malicious users from designing threats that specifically circumvent these published rules. However, AWS does describe what each rule does and the value add for each managed rule group to your WAF configuration. Versioning. A managed rule group provider updates a rule group and gives options to maintain different versions. So customers get to choose a specific version of a particular rule group. Occasionally, when a provider might have to update a new version of a particular rule group, customers are given a choice to opt in for their favorite version or their preferred version. Let's take a look at available managed rule groups. Baseline managed rule groups. These rule groups provide general protection against a wide variety of common threats. For instance, the core rule set managed rule group contains rules that are generally applicable to web applications and provides protections against exploitation of a wide range of vulnerabilities and commonly occurring vulnerabilities that are described in OWASP publications. The use case specific rule groups provide incremental protection for many diverse AWS WAF use cases. Depending upon your workload being protected, you can choose one or more of these rule groups. The IP reputation list rule groups allow you to block requests based on the source IP and reputation. For example, the Amazon IP reputation list is a compilation of IPs detected on Amazon network that are deemed highly likely to be malicious. Other than these three categories, we do offer additional threat mitigation capabilities using AWS WAF bot control and account takeover protection. There will be separate videos in this series that will be describing them in detail. Let's get started. I'll quickly show you how to add an AWS WAF managed rule group to an existing web ACL using AWS WAF console.
To add a managed rule group to a web ACL through the console, first sign into AWS management console and open the AWS WAF console. You begin by choosing web ACLs in the navigation pane. In the web ACLs page, from the list of web ACLs, select the one that you want to add the rule group to. This takes you to the page for the single web ACL. In your web ACL page, choose the rules tab. In the rules pane, choose add rules and then choose add managed rule groups. In the add managed rule groups page, expand the selection for your rule group vendor to see a list of available rule groups. For each rule group that you want to add, choose add to web ACL. If you want to make changes to the web ACL configuration of the rule group, choose edit, make your changes, and then choose save rule. At the bottom of your add manage rule groups page, choose add rules to proceed further. In the set rule priority page, adjust the order that the rules have to run as needed. Then choose save. Now that you've seen how to add this to your web ACL, you could do something similar using AWS CLI or AWS APIs.
AWS managed rules are designed to protect you from common web threats. When used in accordance with our best practices and documentation, AWS managed rules add another layer of security for your applications. However, AWS managed rules are not intended as a replacement for your security responsibilities, which are determined by the AWS resources that you select. Please refer to shared responsibility model to ensure that your resources in AWS are properly protected.
Hope this information will help you get started with AWS managed rules, and I would recommend going through our documentation for further reading. Thanks for your time and happy cloud computing from all of us at AWS.